What is up? What is good? Wolf's here once again with another E3 2017 EA press conference trailer. So let's break it down. Let's react to it and everything. We're going into a little Star Wars. The PlayStation logo popped up on there first too, which is something. In game, I wonder if they could pull like a Titanfall thing where you fly in on the ship and you're sitting there looking at, you know, all the stormtroopers around you. Why they put jobbers in this game when everybody pretty much just skipped over the jobbers in the last game. It's good that you have a little more diverse of characters in the different stuff. So heavy machine guns feel a lot more like a heavy machine gun, not just a run around assault rifle. That was a pretty cool little upgrade that they did. Not clear. It is Darth Maul coming to kick our ass. For the first time that I can remember in a Star Wars game, especially an online Star Wars game, we can actually play as freaking Darth Maul. Like, everybody's wanted that for so long. We're finally getting in this. We got Chewie. We got the Imperial, I think, or something like that. Boba Fett, Yoda. We got Rey. Kylo Ren, but who cares about Kylo Ren? I didn't like Kylo Ren at all. Just Millennium Falcon right there. Han Solo's good old thing. Now, this is the brand new story DLC that everybody wanted so prominently in the first game. Kind of like Rogue One, but we actually get to play, you know, through the story mode in this one. Pre-order, you get the early beta access. Now, of course, early beta access on PS4, probably early EA access on Xbox. So either which way you go. Oh, and I'm pretty sure EA Origins on the PC, you're going to be getting some stuff on there also. So just very, very cinematic. I think that they're trying to go for like the cinematic multiplayer, kind of like Titanfall did. But instead of it being like an actual story mode built into the multiplayer, you have a regular story mode around the side, and then you have your, which the multiplayer seems to be going more esports competitive. These maps seem a lot more kind of like shrunken down, so you're not all over the place, but you can still have your tanks and your vehicles, and you still got the flying in there and all that stuff. So it makes it a lot easier to stream and also have competitions where you always have action going on the screen. It's not just a lot of run around and not have anything happening. You know, that happens in game live right there. So maybe we'll see some cash prize esports stuff, tournaments going on with the teams and everything, just like we do with Call of Duty, and I think Battlefield has a couple of them and whatnot, but Gears and Halo and Call of Duty, like those arena style shooters, you can't do those in a simulation full-on epic battle scene. It just doesn't work because there's too much downtime. There's too much of just running around. Space battles. Imagine having an esports thing where it's like space battles and everything. What's mind blown right there? All of a sudden, just a Millennium Falcon comes flying through for one of the teams or something. Like, it's crazy seeing it. So like I said, Rogue One, that was a standalone to tie in like the episodes of the Star Wars, because there's a lot of stories and everything in between the movies, the Star Wars movies, that you don't get to see. So this way you actually get, you know, your hands-on time with those stories and everything. So very, very awesome. Elite Trooper Deluxe Edition, that is most likely going to be, you know, like the little statue figurine or whatever, and the DLC of course coming with it. So lot of very cool stuff. Maybe we'll see some more of it during the Sony press conference. I'm pretty sure that's in a couple days. Yes. So there you have it. This game, now one of the biggest things when I heard Battlefront 2, I was like, please don't be just like DLC, like $60 DLC pretty much. This seems like a full-on brand new package deal. A lot of what made the first game very good, it feels like Battlefield but with the Star Wars theme, and on top of that there's so much new stuff in it that I feel like it does actually warrant the full-on $60 price tag to make it a brand new game. And the biggest one of all the DLC, it seems like all the DLC anyways, they said 8 packs of free characters and maps and everything. So pretty much all the DLC for this game is going to be for free. Not a bad deal at all. $60, boom, and then all your DLC right there for you. So you're going to have plenty of stuff to do, not like the first one where it was like it's fun for a few hours and you get kind of sick of it because you played everything. This one seems to be legit. Hopefully there's going to be one more Star Wars game also coming out, which is a story-driven Star Wars game, kind of like The Force Unleashed was. Hopefully that is going to be really cool. Some of the people that worked at Naughty Dog is working on that one, so hopefully during Sony press conference we'll see that pop up also. Anyways, I can't say much more about this game because the only thing else I can do is get hands-on with it. So thanks for checking this trailer out and or checking this video out with me. Talking over the trailer, yeah. And yeah, I will see you on the next video.